scriptures will tell you that the Christian life ought to consist of one victory after another. And that if you're experiencing defeat in your life, then there's something wrong with you. That your faith is weak, or maybe you're not even a true believer. But don't listen to them, because I'm going to tell you something. If suffering defeat is a sign of weak faith, then Jesus himself was a poor Christian. For though he enjoyed victories in his life and ministry on earth, his time here was also marked by pain and suffering. The real hope for us is not found in trouble-free living, but in living under the cross and the crown, accepting pain and blessing from the hand of God according to his good and gracious will, trusting that in the end, he will raise us up in triumph over sin and death, granting to us a share in his ultimate victory to life everlasting.
Time there's been the fight to win the heart and soul of man.
Slithering in Eden was the serpent undermining our God's plan.
Do not eat from this one tree, for doing so will surely bring you death.
Riding at his heels, the tempter always questions what the Father said.
The two paths intertwine, one blessing. Turn in faith to him, he'll carry us through all the ups and downs.
When we fall, he lifts us up and sets our feet upon the solid ground.
Bearing the crown, bearing the cross, sharing the glory, suffering the loss, knowing the joy, feeling the pain, living the life, we got the gain, standing to temptation, falling to sin, being forgiven, balance to win, the trophy is his, for he laid his life down, he bore the cross, yeah, to give us the crown.
Do not fear what you're about to suffer. Behold, the devil will throw some of you into prison that you may be tested, and you will have tribulation, but be faithful unto death, and I will give you the crown of life.
Soon will whisper in your ear to go ahead and take the fall.
Take a bite of that forbidden fruit, for you deserve it after
and
all.
Jesus weeps again to see the damage and the hurt it causes you.
You suffer, he's prepared for you another victory.